Good afternoon, sorry, good morning all, and welcome to this lecture of electronics in which we are going to study oscillators. This is basically the syllabus of semester 4, paper 1, electronics, and RTM Nagpur University, Nagpur. Myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Electronics, Sri Mathura Das Mota College of Science. I welcome you all in this lecture. And today we are going to start with oscillators, the basics of oscillators. So let me share my screen on that. I guess my screen is visible to you. As I've introduced myself. As I've introduced myself, Dr. N.D. Meshram, Head and Associate Professor, Department of Electronics, Sri Mathura Das Mota College of Science. And today we are going to study the basics of oscillators. Now, there are two things that are correlated, the amplifiers and the oscillators, right? So we have understood what are amplifiers. Amplifiers are basically which amplifies the amplitude of a signal. That those are called as amplifiers. And the difference between the amplifier and the oscillators are the oscillators generate their own signals, right? Those are called as oscillators without any external circuitry. So just a power supply is attached to that those circuits, and they give us a sinusoidal wave or a triangular wave or a say square wave in .NET, and they have different names also on that. Oscillators actually are the circuits which are going to generate AC signals, right, of different frequencies. So those are called as oscillators, and today amplifiers are only going to amplify the signals which are being given to those amplifiers. So they are going to amplify the amplitude of that those particular signals, right? So yeah, today we are going to start with that. These are oscillators. The objectives behind this lecture is to describe the basic concept of an oscillator and discuss the basic principles of operation of an oscillator. So we are having many kinds of oscillators, Wien bridge oscillator, crystal oscillator, and say the Hartley oscillator. There is one more using NOT gate, that is actually the crystal oscillator. Then phase shift oscillator is there. There are different sorts of oscillators. What are their basic principles? And what is the concept behind an oscillator? That is what we are expected to study in this class. Then to analyze the operation of RC and LC oscillators. Yes, RC are the components which determines the frequency and which are responsible to generate this frequency. So I, if there is someone, kindly unmute themselves, please. So yeah, so these are the concepts which we are expected to study. And to describe the operations of describe the operation of the basic relaxation oscillator. So relaxation oscillators are those which generates the ramp circuit. And okay, yes. So relaxation oscillator also we are going to study. These are all sorts of oscillators which we are expected to complete in this section. So one by one, as the time progresses, so we'll be doing that. So so the main objectives of this lecture is to describe the concept of an oscillator, basic principles of operation of an oscillator, then RC and LC oscillators, operation of basic relaxation oscillator circuits and all. Then, yeah, the introduction of this is oscillator is an electronic circuit, as I told you, that generates a periodic waveform on its output, right, without any external signal as an input, right? So they are going to generate the signal onto themselves without any input, right? So they are going to generate a sinusoidal wave or a square wave or say in that case triangular wave and just using the DC power supply. So it is used to convert a DC to a AC. Now, these we'll study also the applications of this oscillator. So I guess you understood what is the concept of oscillator. Repeat it for you. Oscillator is an electronic circuit that generates a periodic waveform. So which goes on repeating in equal interval of time. Those are called as periodic waveforms on its output without an external signal source, without giving a input to that circuit, right? So we are not going to give the input, but yes, of course, we are going to apply the power supply to it. So using that power supply, this particular circuit, which we are calling it as an oscillator, is going to generate the signals, right? So those signals might be sine wave, say a square wave and a triangular wave, and the other waveforms like. So these particular circuits are called as the oscillators. Now it is used to convert a DC to AC. Now, as I told you, that these circuits are going to require a DC source. We need to connect a power supply to them. Then only they are going to be energized, and they are going to generate these AC or sinusoidal waveforms, right? So they are nothing but the converters of AC to DC. Then the oscillators are the circuits that produce a continuous signal of some type without the need. Without the need of an input. So we have not applied the input, but still they are going to generate the continuous signal. Now how they are going to do that is what we are going to study in different oscillators. There are some basic principles of it. So let us see how much we can complete today. So oscillators are circuits that produce a continuous signal of some type without the need of an input. Now these signals serve a variety of purpose. So yeah, what are the applications of these oscillators? Why we are studying these oscillators and where they are required? So these oscillators are basically required in the communication system to generate the frequencies. Now, as I'm talking to you, I'm generating an audio frequency wave, right? So which is going to say deteriorate as it passes with respect to time. So this is actually the sine wave. Now, if I want to communicate to a distant place, so what I need to do is I have to mix my frequency, mix my audio voice with a higher frequency, and then I am able to communicate. So that is being used in the communication system. Some of the digital systems we require these oscillators, including computers also. And test equipments which make use of oscillators. So in some of the test equipments, we require this oscillations, we require these frequencies for comparison, and accordingly, the test equipments, the measuring instruments give you the result, right? So these are some of the applications. In depth, we are going to study those. In semester 5, you are having a whole chapter on communication system. So a whole paper on communication systems. So you'll be studying their different types of communication systems, right? So yeah, so these are some of the applications of oscillators. I guess you have understood what are actual the oscillators, and we are going to study the circuits. Now which type of oscillations they are going to provide. So oscillations, an effect that repeatedly and regularly fluctuates about the mean value, those are called as oscillations. These are some definitions. Oscillator, circuit that produce these oscillations, and characteristics, wave shape in that oscillations, what are the characteristics that we are expecting to come. Those are wave shapes, means we are having a sine wave, we are having a square wave, so we are having different wave shapes. Then we are having frequency associated with that particular wave, so that is a sine wave, and it is associated with some of the frequency, right? So frequency, then we are expected to have the amplitude. So everything which we need in an AC signal or a square wave, that is there, those parameters. Then we are having distortion. They are actually, which we actually are not acceptable. So distortions are there, then we are having stability, right? So stability is very, very important, because the waves which we need to generate, should remain constant in frequency, amplitude, and their shape. So they are not; they should not go be disturbed as the time passes. So stability is very important. So these are some of the characteristics which the oscillators or the oscillations are being required. So oscillation, which means an effect that repeatedly and regularly fluctuates about the mean value, which is not going to change, but it will remain constant and it will repeat itself in equal interval of time. Those are called as oscillations. Oscillator which is going to produce these oscillations are called as an oscillator. And the characteristics of these oscillations are it should have a wave shape, a definite wave shape. It should have a frequency. It should have an amplitude. It might have distortion and it should have a stability, right? So these are the characteristics of oscillators, and these are some of the applications of oscillators. As I told you that oscillators are used to generate signals, for example, used as a local oscillator to transform the RF signals, that is radio frequency signal, into the intermediate frequency signals in a receiver, right? So these are actually required for the communication systems to communicate lower frequency to our higher frequency, right? So local oscillators to transform radio frequency signals to IF signals in a receiver, then used to generate RF carrier in a transmitter, that is radio frequency carrier in a transmitter. So in communication system, we require three blocks. The one is called as a transmitter, the other one is called as the receiver, and the in between we are having the channel through which we are going to transfer the data or through which we are expected to communicate, right? So we are having three blocks, the transmitter, receiver, and the communication channel, right? So the radio frequency to multiplex or to kindly unmute yourself. So transmitter, which is going to transmit. Now, what I need to do is I have to modulate my wave. So modulation means to mix my lower voice frequency with a higher voice frequency. So I'll be requiring the radio frequency waves at the range of, say, around 40 or 50 kilohertz, whereas my audible range is from, say, 200 hertz to 5 kilohertz or 4 kilohertz only. Right, so this frequency I need to mix it with a higher frequency so that I could transfer this frequency to a higher distance. Right, so that's there is where the oscillators are being employed. Now the other uses are used to generate the clocks in digital signals. So initially we require to generate a AC signal, then we put a circuit which converts that sine wave into a square wave. Right, so those are actually the digital systems. I have already told you in the earlier classes that the square waves, which we call it as a clock pulses, which we require which the microprocessor requires to carry or to perform some operations on that. So particular one clock pulse will do one job at a time. Second one is used as a sweep circuits in TV sets and CROs. We have seen CROs in the labs. So CROs in which they are going to generate these signals. So we are actually able to see those signals on these CROs. CRO means cathode ray oscilloscopes. So there was one whole unit of CRO in semester one. So we have studied CROs, and on that basis only TV sets are being designed, the earlier TV sets. Today we are having LED TVs, so these are all now outdated, where we were having the picture tubes. So the concept of those were working on these sweep circuits, which actually were made by using UJTs, unijunction transistors and all, right? So these are some of the applications. Then, yeah, so oscillators are circuits that generate periodic signals, as I told you. Now, let us see. An oscillator converts DC power from the power supply into AC signal, power spontaneously without the need for an AC input source. So, we are not applying any input, but yes, we are going to give it the DC supply to that circuit, right? And this is actually a sawtooth wave circuit. Sawtooth is actually having a straight line over here, then a ramp, then a straight line. That is called as sawtooth. Sawtooth means वो जो आरी होती है, काटने वाली आरी होती है, उसका जैसे एक-एक teeth होते हैं, उस प्रकार से. So this is a sawtooth waveform, right? Triangular waveforms are triangles. So both on both sides there will be say the ramps. So that those are called as triangular waves, then square waves, and then sine waves. So I'll be showing those slides over there. Yeah. So this slide shows you the, what are actually the waveforms that are being generated by these oscillators, right? So an oscillator is a circuit that produces a repetitive signal from a DC voltage. The feedback oscillator relies on a positive feedback of the output to maintain the oscillations. And the relaxation oscillator makes use of an RC timing circuit to generate a non-sinusoidal signal such as a square wave. So sine wave is being converted into square wave by using this RC circuit. So just a RC circuit, if you put it in front of a sine wave oscillator, then it will show you, give you the square waves. Now, just look at this diagram. So this is the block, the circuits which we are going to study in the coming classes. So I'm taking it as a box, right? So this is a block level diagram, and we are just applying a DC supply over here. And in the output, we are expected to have these sine waves. So this is a sine wave. And this is what actually are being visualized on the CROs. So unfortunately, we are not able to perform your practicals. But if else, cross your fingers, and if the time permits and we are able to perform your practicals, then you'll be experiencing these types of sine waves on the CROs itself by the circuits which are being designed by you and me. So Wen bridge oscillator and phase shift oscillator will give you these sorts of waveforms. So this is actually the sinusoidal waveform. Why we call them as a sinusoidal waveform? Because they appear as per the sine formula of angle, sine theta, right? So sine theta, sine zero is zero, sine one is, sine 90 is one. And then again, sine 180 is zero, then sine minus 270, 270 is minus one, then again, sine 360 is zero. So this whole performs as a sinusoidal angle. So that is why we call them as a sine wave, right? So this is actually the sine wave. And the second one is square wave. If you put a RC circuit in front of the sine wave, the output of that circuit, which is going to give the sine wave. If you put RC circuit, just a resistance and a capacitor circuit, resistance connected in series and capacitor in parallel, you'll be getting this type of a square wave. So this is a square wave. And this is a sawtooth wave. So this is a sawtooth. This is not a triangular wave. So there are many sorts of waves. This is a sine wave. There is cosine wave also. Then square wave. Sine wave and cosine waves are nearly same. Sine wave, square wave, and sawtooth wave. There is one more, that is a triangular wave. So the circuits which are expected to generate these types of signals are called as oscillators. So remember this. The block level diagram I am showing you. This circuits we are going to study in this. Now, how they are going to do, what is the principle behind that? That is what we need to study. Now, what are the types of oscillators? So there are RC oscillators, means resistance and capacitance connected oscillators. RC means resistance and capacitance. So that is phase bridge oscillator, then phase shift oscillators. Then LC, that is inductance and capacitor connected circuits. Implemented circuits where we are having L, that is inductor, and C is for again capacitor. So if you need to design a LC circuit in which we are expected to have an inductor as well as the capacitor, then we can design these circuits. So these are Hartley and Colpitts oscillator. We have all designed these circuits in our lab itself. So Wen bridge oscillator, phase shift oscillator are RC oscillators. LC oscillators are Hartley and Colpitts oscillator. They are a little bit difficult to implement. And the last one is the crystal oscillator. So we are having crystals, piezoelectric crystals, which are going to generate, waveforms, right? And for that, we'll be requiring a NOT gate circuit. Those oscillators are a higher frequency oscillators, actually crystals, which give square waves, right? So those are also oscillators. Then this is the third type, that is the unijunction or the relaxation oscillators, which are actually made by using UJT, right? So unijunction transistor. We are using those, and those are called as the relaxation oscillators, right? So, yeah. Then these are some of the linear oscillators which I was telling you, this is the basic concept behind the linear oscillator. Now, how it oscillates, this is the basic principle. So if you are able to see, we are having an amplifier circuit over here, and this is actually the concept of the oscillators, right? So we are having an amplifier circuit over here. This block where A is written, this is called as an amplifier, which is going to give you amplification. And then the output is feedback to a feedback circuit. The gain of this amplifier is supposed to be AF, and the gain of this feedback circuit, which we are calling it as beta. So this A and beta, the gain should be equal to this plus this should be equal to 1, and it will give you the output as the sine wave, right? So this is the basic concept of, say, the oscillators. So how they go on giving the oscillations, because of this feedback circuit, right? So because of this feedback circuit, so this feedback circuit is going to produce the gain. Now the multi product of both the gains, which is so the gain of the amplifier as well as the gain of the feedback circuits, are supposed to be 1, or say in terms of phase angle, it should be equal to say 0 degree or 360 degrees. So if this feedback circuit is going to give you a 360 degree phase shift, means this amplifier is going to give you 180, and this feedback circuit is again going to give you 180 degree phase shift. So both are going to give you 360 degrees, and that will go on generating the AC signals, right? So yes, so these are some of the explanations, switching oscillators. Another approach to oscillator design, it employs active devices as switches rather than linear amplifiers. This is a circuit, and I will be having a derivation on it. But yes, of course, derivation is not in your syllabus. So this is actually the diagram. So whenever we provide, the source, the voltage supply over here to the amplifier, it is going to produce a signal. Now this signal is going to give feedback to this circuit, which we are calling it as the feedback circuit. And this feedback circuit is going to generate a phase shift of 180 degrees. This amplifier is going to provide 180 degree phase shift, and this is going to provide you the another 180 degree phase shift, and adding both that in over here will give you a 360 degree phase shift, right? So as we get 360 degree phase shift, the output is being fed back again, and it goes on oscillating, right? So this is how it works as an oscillator. So this is actually called as the Barkhausen criteria. For sinusoidal input is connected linear because the output is approximately sinusoidal. A linear oscillator contains a frequency selection feedback network, an amplifier to maintain the loop gain at unity, right? So I told you that this gain, that is A in this amplifier, and this gain of this feedback circuit is beta. So A and beta should give you a unity gain, right? So unity gain means the gain of 1. So A beta should be equal to 1. And that particular equation is called as the Barkhausen criteria, right? We'll be studying those in depth. So this is the derivation of that Barkhausen criteria. And as I've told you, A beta should be equal to 1. And as far as angle is concerned, A beta should be equal to 0 degree or 360 degrees, right? And this particular equation is called as the Barkhausen criteria. And this is how it is being, say, calculated, which is not in our syllabus right now. So, this is required for oscillations. Unless and until we are having this situation, so AV beta or A beta should be equal to 1, and the angle, that is phase angle, A beta should be equal to 0 degrees or 360 degrees. I guess this much is enough for today. I will just repeat it what we have studied in this class, and we'll conclude. Yeah. So we have started today with the topic of oscillators, hopefully semester 4 paper 1 unit 1, in which the oscillators are there. So we are going to study the oscillators, different sorts of oscillators, and what are the basic concepts of oscillators. So we have started with this. These are the basic objectives behind studying this, which we will be continuing in the next classes. The definition of oscillator is an electronic circuit that generates a periodic waveform on its output without an external signal source. It is used to convert a DC to AC. Oscillators are circuits that produce a continuous signal of some type without the need of an input. So without giving any input, it is going to generate signals. Those are called as oscillators. Now, these signals serve a variety of purposes. Some of them for the communication systems, the others are for digital systems, including computers, and for some test equipment for measurement. So oscillations, these are which are the effects that repeatedly and regularly fluctuates about the mean value. So they are going to be the same, but they should repeat themselves in equal interval of time. That is the meaning of fluctuates about the mean value, right? And the circuit which is going to produce these oscillations are called as an oscillator. The characteristics of those are wave shape. The shape is very important, square, sine, square wave, and then sawtooth and triangular. Frequency, wave shape, amplitude, distortion, stability. These are some of the applications which we have already discussed. Then oscillators are like this. So this is how the sine waves, square waves, and sawtooth waves are being generated by these oscillators. And these are some of the types of oscillators. So these are RC oscillators, where we are employing resistance and capacitance. So those oscillators are called as the RC oscillators, in which we are having two types of oscillators, Wien bridge oscillator and a phase shift oscillator. Then for LC oscillators, means L means inductor, C means again capacitor. So LC oscillators are having Hartley and Colpitts oscillator. So these are the types of LC oscillators, and there is one more which we call it as a crystal oscillator. This crystal oscillator is basically a piezoelectric crystal, right? So yeah, and the third type of oscillator is the unijunction transistor oscillator or a relaxation oscillator. So both are same. So we are going to study those. This is the basic concept of linear oscillators, in which we are going to give the AC DC supply to this amplifier, and the output of this DC supply is being fed back to a feedback circuit, and this output of this feedback circuit is again given to this amplifier, and thus they produce a gain of 1, means both amplifier as well as the feedback circuit, that is A and beta, which we are expecting as the gain of the amplifier, and beta as the gain of the feedback circuit. A beta should be equal to 1, or in terms of phase angle, A beta should give you a 0° phase shift or a 360° phase shift. Then only the oscillations will start. So yes, this is the derivation of that, and this is not in your syllabus, but still for understanding, I'm going to tell you. And this is the condition which we call this as the Barkhausen criteria. A beta is equal to 1, and angle, that is A beta, should be equal to 0, or say in that case 360°. Both are same. So 0° or 360°. And if this condition is satisfied by this circuit, then it will generate the oscillations, or it will give you a sinusoidal wave. So by today, I guess it is enough for today. So thank you very much for joining. If you have any questions, we will be able to I'll be able to answer that. Yeah, am I audible? Somebody has written that I'm not audible. Nikshatai, no personal question, please. So I will talk on that. The time is too short, so let me conclude formally. Thank you very much for joining, and I'll be uploading this video on the YouTube channel, so kindly go and visit my YouTube channel and be attentive on the class. Please be regular on the class, and if you have any doubts on the topic, you can ask me anything. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe, take care. see you soon in the next class, hopefully on Wednesday, right? So have a nice day. Bye. Good day. See you soon.